Gabriel Capone was one of 43,000 Italians to immigrate to America in 1894. On January 17, 1899, Gabriel Capone and Teresa Capone gave birth to Alfonso Capone. He was later baptized and given the name Al. A few blocks away from the Capone house was the Garfield place, the headquarters of the most successful gangster of the East Side. This gangster was Johnny Torrio. Johnny Torrio taught Al Capone many useful skills, which he used as a foundation for his gangster empire. As time went on, Torrio's trust in Al grew until he became his lieutenant. After the death of another local gangster, Dion O'Brien, two men who worked for Dion were after Alfonso Capone and Torrio. These two men were Jaime Weiss and Bugs Moran.
Must me forza perderti per sempre o luce mia.
There he is!
After Torrio's injury, he spent 4 months in the hospital. Then he went to jail for other charges. While he was in jail, Capone visited him. While he was there, he was handed over the entire gangster empire. As time went on, his power grew until he controlled Cicero and half of northern Chicago. His income was about $100 million. It would seem that Al Capone was unstoppable, until a cop came in, a cop named Elliot Ness. There was no evidence that Al Capone was orchestrating any of these murders, or murdering himself. No money laundering, nothing. Nothing was directly to him. He always had an alibi, and that was where Elliot Ness got him. He tried him for income tax evasion, because he had never filed a tax return. During the trial, Elliot Ness had found a bribery list, where $3,600 were paid to each juror, including the judge, Judge Wilkerson.
Bailiff?
Judge Edwards has another trial today. I want you to switch the jury.
Order!
Your Honor, what is this?
Order! Where's the justice?
We'd like to change our plea to guilty.
What are you talking about?
The name was on the bribery list.
Order!
After being sentenced 11 years, he was sent to the Atlanta Penitentiary. He paid off the guard and lived better than all the other prisoners. He had more sheets, more socks, more clothing, more everything than all the other prisoners. He could drink, he could eat, at any time he wanted. In August of 1934, word of this got out, and Al Capone was sent to Alcatraz, the tightest prison in the US. He knew nothing of the outside world, and soon, his syphilis from an earlier age took over his mind until he gained syphilitic dementia. He was released early in November of 1939, and he lived with his wife until 1947, until pneumonia took over his syphilitic dementia, and he passed away.
My poor.